Garikoitz lerma usabia badugu, bera BCBL-etik dator, eta ikusmena, irakurketa, eta erresonantzia magnetikoa, eta hori guztiak ba, biltzen ditu bere egunerokotasunean.
Hello, good morning. So I've been asked to give the presentation in English, and my accent is not very good, so I think you will follow okay. Otherwise, in the poster session, you can ask in Basque or Spanish as well. So my name is Gary Coitz, and I've got some age, and I've been doing some circles in my professional life. So instead of focusing on the science I do, that you can ask later on the poster, and I want to talk about the decision that made me arrive to the way I'm right now. And one thing is that I think that you are feeling a lot of pressure now that you need to choose what to study. And as the other people were saying, you can always change. And I want to show you how all the change I've been doing during my my professional career. So one way of organizing where would you like to work in the future is that there are three main areas where you can work, right? One is the university, academia, research environment. That usually is the place where the knowledge is created. And then you can go into consultancy, where they take the knowledge created in the research centers and apply into industry or government, and you create policies or whatever. And I've been doing one circle. So I studied engineering here in San Sebastian, and I went and I did an Erasmus and Leonardo project in Scotland and in Germany. Then I went to Madrid and Barcelona to work for consultancy, so IBM and PricewaterhouseCoopers, working for big clients, you know, industry and government clients. And meanwhile, I was working for IBM. I did an MBA, a Master in Business Administration, because I didn't want to continue working in consultancy. I wanted to know more, so I did an MBA to see what else I could do with my life. And what I did was I created a couple of small companies that they don't exist anymore, but. They did for 10 years or something like this, and I was working there. And meanwhile, I was working there, I wanted to change again, and I started doing a PhD in Lasalle. At first, it was dedicated to business and entrepreneurship, but this kind of stuff. But I got in touch with neuroscience. Meanwhile, I was doing the PhD. And I decided to quit all of the companies and this kind of work. And I started a PhD here in BCBR, which is right there. It's a research center in language, reading, this kind of stuff. And after that, I went to Stanford University for 3 years with a stay in NYU in New York. That's true that if you like to travel, scientific career it's very good because not only you can live elsewhere, you can there are many conferences all over the world, and they usually are in very nice places, and it's a nice way of living if you like to travel. And I think that's it. So what I do is I work with MRI, with magnetic resonance imaging, and it's basically the same thing you find in the hospitals, but we use it for research. That's what, and we just only work with the head. So the rest of the thing we don't use it. We just check what's going on inside our heads. One of the advantages of MRI, I will, if anybody wants to know more details about my science, we can talk on the poster later on. But one of the advantages is that you can use MRI to obtain many different images. So you can see where. Your thoughts are happening, or you can see what are the connections between different parts of the brain, or many different types of images and research. And for example, this is research in neuroscience,